Good morning. I am Dr. Rajeev Chawla, Director, North Delhi Diabetes Center, Rohini, New Delhi. Today in IDEC, I spoke on refining atherosclerotic cardiovascular risk in type 2 diabetes as a tool for sort of incorporating that into the anti-hyperglycemic therapy so as to reduce overall cardiovascular risk and to have its role in primary prevention. We know that type 2 diabetic patients, they are at a very high risk of developing subclinical atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, and risk of developing atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease is almost 2 to 6 times in the setting of type 2 diabetes. In fact, many times atherosclerosis may precede or even the onset of type 2 diabetes because they have a common soil hypothesis in its propagation, and it is possibly insulin resistance which is a common link between development of atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease as well as type 2 diabetes. So it is very, very important these days to stratify this risk by using various risk engines in the setting of type 2 diabetes. Various risk engines which are available are like UKPDS score, QRIS score also is available, and based on the Framingham risk scoring also we can do find out patients who are going to be at a high risk for CV mortality in setting of type 2 diabetes. So once we evaluate these patients, maybe there are ways to do a non-invasive risk stratification also by using at times in ABI certain echocardiography findings. Also you can do a flow mediated vasodilation, which could be a marker of endothelial dysfunction, that can also be checked on the bedside, or even you can look for an augmentation index in the setting of type 2 diabetes to stratify the risk of atherosclerosis in these patients with type 2 diabetes. And once you have graded these patients in terms of risk, it is better then we incorporate therapies which can reduce this risk to overall cut down on cardiovascular mortality. And best options are that after metformin, we should choose drugs like SGLT2 inhibitors or GLP-1 analog, which can reduce overall risk by cutting on 3-point MACE in these settings. And those patients who are sort of obese or overweight, they're also not only you get a weight reduction by these drugs, they also cut down on CV death, overall risk of hospitalization for heart failure or non-fatal MI. So overall 3-point MACE reduction happens if you are using a drug like SGLT2 or maybe GLP-1 analog after metformin, which could be a wonderful option. Thank you.